Today we're going to learn about control and regulation of monopoly. So why do we need to control or regulate monopolies? We do that to protect the interest of the consumers. We already talked about how monopoly firms are price makers. If the prices rise above the competitive equilibrium, the monopolist would still earn supernormal profits, but it would hurt the ones who cannot afford to buy the good. That is why we need to control or regulate monopolies. Now, how does the government control and regulate monopoly? The governments can do that directly through imposing laws like the anti-monopoly laws and restrictive trade practices legislations. They can also run natural monopolies. Natural monopolies are a type of monopoly where there's high startup cost and the first company enjoys huge economies of scale and advantage over its competitors. For example, let's take electricity. If there's another company producing electricity, it would not be beneficial as the average cost would be very high. It does not make sense for another company to be setting up electricity grids all over the city. The capital that's needed would be very high and the average cost of production would be high as well. So governments usually run them. And if it's a private firm that's running the natural monopoly, the government can regulate it by imposing price ceiling. Monopolies can also be regulated through taxes, but it's not always the case that the monopolies impose high prices if they are not regulated, because there are certain fears that prevent the monopolist from charging high prices. So the first one is the fear of potential rivals. The fear of potential competitors, they prevent a monopolist to charge a very high price from the customers. If the monopolist sets a very high price, he is going to earn large supernormal profits. And attracted by these monopoly profits, new competitors may enter the market and the monopolist doesn't want that. So he'd rather charge a reasonable price and earn lesser amount of supernormal profits than attract competitors into his market. And the next is the fear of government regulation. So the monopolist is well aware that charging unusually high prices or profits is going to attract the attention of the government. So rather risking government regulation and intervention, he's going to voluntarily fix a low price and earn less monopoly profits. There's also the fear of nationalization. So this prevents the monopolist to wield an absolute monopoly power. Because if the product or service which the monopolist produces is a public utility service, there is every likelihood of the state taking over the monopoly organization in public interest, knowing that if the monopolist charges a high price, they may not be able to afford it. So this consideration is going to prevent the monopolist from charging a very high price. And there's also the fear of public reaction. So monopolist, if he charges a very high price and earns huge profits, there may be voices raised against the monopoly firm in the parliament to press for anti-monopoly legislations. Then we have fear of boycott. People may even boycott the use of monopoly's product and start their own service instead. For example, if there's a big city where taxi operators combine and charge high rates, people may boycott the taxi service and start operating their own services by forming a cooperative society. Naturally, such a fear compels monopoly firms to charge reasonable prices and earn only normal profits. Then there's also the fear of substitutes. This is the most potent factor which prevents monopoly firms from charging very high prices and earning supernormal profits. It's only under pure monopoly that there are absolutely no substitutes for the product. But pure monopoly, like pure competition, is not applicable to the real world. So the monopoly product has some form of substitute, though it's not a close substitute. So the fear of emergence of very close substitutes is always uppermost in the mind of monopolists. And this acts as a restraint of his absolute power. And so these are the ways in which the government controls and regulates monopolies. And by regulating and controlling the monopolies, the governments can remove restricted trade practices, can keep the prices in check, can reduce the incidence of market sharing agreements and mergers. To avoid market domination, they can remove unfair competition and unfair price discrimination. And therefore, it's very important that the government controls and regulates those kinds of monopolies. So that's all about the control and regulation of monopolies.